श्री कृष्णा श्री कृष्णा श्री कृष्णा श्री कृष्णा गुरुर्ब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णुः गुरुर्देवो महेश्वरः गुरुसाक्षात् परं ब्रह्म तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः त्रिपुरारस्य 14 चैप्टर concluding session of 2016 ityakarne muno muni vacho vicharya shubhaya adhiya jagastitim swapna samam jnatva ashokam jahodrutam dhairyamalambya nishoko bhuyo pruchan mune sudam muni putra mahabuddhe tvam paravara darshanah tatah api aviditam kachin me malne syaditi leshatah pruchhami yadaham tanme kripaya vaktum arhasi. The king Mahasen said, "Hey Muniputra, what you told?" Conclusion was, the waking world is exactly and equal to the dream world. There is no difference whatsoever. No difference. What you said, I agree. But, see, this butting is a business which keeps us away from the truth. And this will not keep quiet. It has to be sorted out. See, like, you know, till yesterday we have seen the analysis that there is no difference whatsoever in the waking and the dream experience. Dream experience happens when we get identified with the modifications of the mind, and the waking experience also happens when we get identified with the mind. See? When our identification with the mind is zero, then there is neither waking nor dream. So one experience through the mind, in the waking we take it as real. And another experience through the same mind in the dream we take it as illusion. What logic it is. See? Identification is same. The instrument of identification is also the same. Experiences are also the same. See, friends. So, we have no choice. No, what you say is true. But, so, first of all, what happened to Mahasena? That Jnatva Shokam Jahodrutam. First of all, he stopped being miserable. A miserable person is not in a position to listen and understand and assimilate. First thing, Bhagavad Gita very clearly tells right in the beginning, prasade sarva dukkhanam hanirasyopajayate prasanna chetaso yashu buddhi paryavatishtate. The one who has prasada buddhi means what? Whatever comes in our life is the blessing of the Lord, prasada buddhi. When we go to a temple and we get some prasad, that time what is our attitude towards that prasad? That attitude towards everything that happens in our life is prasada buddhi. When we go to the temple, we get prasad, we feel blessed with whatever comes. We don't compare with others. Hey, you gave him more, you give me less. Third, we don't want to improve upon the prasad. Hey, Saji, tusi, oh, halwa ditta, achar hai kya? No. We take only that halwa as a prasad. We don't want to add anything to that. See, friends, in the same manner, whatever comes in our life, if we take it as prasad, sarva dukkhanam hanihi upajayate, all the miseries of our life dissolve. See? We are all miserable only because we are not ready to accept as the things are. See? And you can see it everywhere. This is what I told you, once you learn the art of learning, from every experience you can get the message of God. Anything you take. I'll give one or two silly experiences. Those who have got curly hair, look at the ladies. Those who have got curly hairs, they will get that straightening press and make their hair straight. What God has given, they are not happy. They want to change. Those who have got straight hairs, they will make the roll things and put on their head like a bampu and... I was in Uttarkashi and there were girls from Vellam school, Dehradun, very posh and high class school. All the useless children of the filthy rich parents are there. And girls are worse than that. So when I was conducting camp for those children, question answer is to be there in the evening. One girl asked this question. Swamiji, do you use rollers? I said, no, I use khada. So the teacher, she scolded the student. Don't ask silly questions. But you only don't ask anything. Then I became more worried or anxious. What is the rollers? Is it shoes? No, Swamiji, then tell me what. No, your hair are curly, so maybe because before you go to sleep, you put the roller and then you come with the curly hair. Ram, Ram, Ram. That day I learned that what is given by the God to the lady, they don't like, including husband. Don't like. Take this message. If we accept the things as they are, you will never be miserable in life. See, friends. And accepting as the things are, prasade sarva dukkhanam ha nirasya upajayate. Then, as a result, prasanna chetasaha. Such a person will be always cheerful and happy. Such a cheerful and happy person alone, buddhi pari paramatmani avatishtate. Then alone he can think of God. See, friends. So here the teacher says that he jnatma shokam jaho drutam. So what he has understood? Only this much, that waking and dream are equal. There is no difference. So as the dream, loss and gain makes no difference to us, similarly this happens in the waking. So for the time being the mind is cool. Thereafter, dhairyam alamba nishokaha bhuya prashpruchan apruchan munehe sutam. Again, with taking more courage, then he said that, hey Mahabuddhe, when you want to ask a question to somebody, you start glorifying that person. Swamiji Maharaj, you are realized, you know. There is one person who tells me, Swamiji, when I will be realized like you? I said, you cannot be realized like me. He said, why? I say, you have no beard, you are a girl. Longer the beard, authentic is the realization. When the beard is maintained by cutting into pieces, then doubtful is the wisdom. And when there is no beard, no possibility of realization. All ammas will kill me, I know that. But who kills? Narayana. So, हे महामुने हे महाबुद्धे हे मुनिपुत्र त्वं परावर दर्शनः बी अटेंटिव परावर इन अवर स्क्रिप्चर द ट्रूथ इज इंडिकेटेड एट थ्री लेवल्स निर्गुण निराकार एट्रीब्यूटलेस फॉर्मलेस रियालिटी देन सगुण निराकार विथ एट्रीब्यूट्स बट नो फॉर्म थर्ड Saguna Sakar, with attributes, with form. Unless our understanding is complete, we will be obsessed. Those who take God to be only Nirguna Nirakar, attributeless, formless, they will start destroying the temples. They also believe in God. But the moment the God has taken a shape, destroy that temple. That form of the God, because obsession. Then the second one are Saguna Nirakar. In this fall the yogis. So they accept God is the inner controller, Antaryami. So he is controlling the heat of the fire, he is controlling the liquidity of the waters, he is controlling the smell in the earth. So he is inner controller, but he doesn't have any form. Saguna Nirakar. And therefore you see, yogis believe too much in their personal efforts. And they are able to achieve that through only efforts. And whenever we achieve through efforts, we become arrogant. We cannot tolerate anybody. You will see yogis, tapasvis, they have got a tremendous anger and they are the mobile shopping centers. Shopping center means they give shop. Tumhara satyanash ho jayega. And ho bhi jata hai. They have that power. See? So, this is Saguna Nirakar. The third one are JSK, 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 Jai Shri Krishna. See? Pushti Margi or Kashti Margi. Pushti Margi is Gujarati. Chappan Bhog. Kashti Margis are Maharashtrians. They will keep on walking from Arandi up to Pandharpur. Kashta. And both of them believe only in Saguna Sakar. See? And then they will quote Tulsidas Ji. When Kahak Bhushundi Ji was told, he said, no, first I want to have the darshan of my Lord Saguna Sakar, and then I will talk about Nirguna Nirakar. See? Wherever there is incomplete knowledge, there is obsession. Those who are obsessed with allopathy, they condemn other pathies. Those who are obsessed with Ayurveda, they ridicule the allopathy. Those who are obsessed with Sabudana Khichdi, they observe fast. And those who are obsessed with naturopathy, they become like a buffalo, sit down in a mud bath and tell, it is so comfortable, just to see other person also sits there. Don't get obsessed. Obsession is not spiritual life. Para avara. The unmanifest and the manifest. Para is unmanifest. Avara is manifest. He who is well versed in both the unmanifest and the manifest reality is Mahabuddhi. He is the most intelligent one. See, friends. Therefore, Paravara Darshanaha. Hey Mahamune, you are Paravara Darshanaha. And Tataha Api Aviditam Kinchinme Syat Iti Leshataha. Although what you told is perfectly already, yet a small little doubt. Swamiji, ek choti si shanka hai. This is, I am just telling you, one person asked me this question. Choti si, he wanted to say doubt or question, so entangled. Choti si shanka hai. Hamne kaha lagu shanka ka ho na, choti si. Choti si shanka, lagu shanka. Narayan. So, leshataha. Pruchami yadavam manne krupaya vaktumarasi. What I told you, please tell me. Bhavana prabhavam yetat sarvam vadasi tat katham. Maya bhuyo bhavi techa na bahi sarvada bhavet. You tell everything is only our imagination. I also imagine. I am the prime minister, but never happens. See, if waking and dream are both our only imagination, projection, sankalpa, thoughts, if everything is happening in the dream because of our own thoughts, why that same thing doesn't happen in the waking? How it is possible? Is it not our question? So, bhavana prabhavam hi etat sarvam vadasi. You are telling that everything is only bhavana pradham. What you think, so it happens. Then tell me, maya bhuyo bhavitecha, एंड वेन आई ट्राई टू इंसिस्ट और डू कल्पना देन आई शुड बी क्लियरिंग दिस एग्जामिनेशन इन वन गो बट इट नेवर हैपन्स. I want to get married to that girl, but it never happens. What is the reason? So, katham sarvada bhaved, toya tu bhavana siddhya shailo lokya prakalpita, atha api desha kala yuga dvidha katham. You only projected that huge universe in that small rock with a circumference of only 1 kilometer or 1 mile. In that 1 mile circumference rock, you have created the whole world which you showed me very clearly by your own bhavana, by your only thought, and now also, outside also, atha api, deshaha kalascha yugapat, and here also, we are in the similar kind of world. Now there are two time scales. In your world, the time scale was 1 day, and in this world where we are now, the time scale is 2 million years or 12 million years. How simultaneously you are bhavana, you are projecting, there it was 1 year, 1 day, and here it was so many years. Simultaneously, how can you think of two time zones or two time scales? For that you have to go to USA. There are many times it happens. You board the flight at 7 o'clock in the morning and you land at 7 o'clock in the morning because of the time zone. You cross and it is a one hour difference. So you boarded the flight at 7 o'clock and got down at 7 o'clock. So practically you are not traveled, but you are traveled. See, two time zones. So how this is possible? Tatra satya amanyat itarat kadaram tan mama irya iti prushtos munisudha pravaktum upachakrame. Therefore, tell me, between these two time zones, one must be real, one must be unreal. Both cannot be real. So kindly tell me how I should accept both are real. I agree, one should be real, both cannot be real. Reality is only one. So please tell me. Now here the theme begins in a very deep manner. Sankalpo bhavana prokta siddha asiddha iti cha dvidha siddhi sankalpas bhedaha avikalpastva anishthite. Sankalpa is bhavana. Bhavana means what? You do sankalpa. Sankalpa means samyakalpana. Samyakalpana means a firm resolution. When you people do the various kinds of Vedic puja or this Pauranik puja, what is the first thing that the Panditji gives you? Little rice in your hand. Don't eat it. So rice is given. And then little bit, what you call, flour is given, little bit of water, and then you close your hand, and then the Panditji tells you, repeat after me, and we don't know what to say, we also move, mamopata, samastha dhrita kshayadvarasan, after that sankalpa is done, then that sankalpa is offered, and then it becomes a karma. So, sankalpa is a commitment without any change. Our sankalpas are so unsteady. I think I should go for satsang. Satsang means what is there? Every day the same, the world is unreal and the mind is like that and you are not body identified, you are divine. How many times? I think I should not go. But then what will I do at home? I think let me go, Okay, let me go. You get ready, come out. Then somebody comes. Are Guptani, chalo picture jaati, haan chalo. We are like the, furniture. Anybody can move us anywhere. Friends, very deep thought, be attentive. We all have two expressions of the infinite energy expressing through us. वन इज द एनर्जी कॉल्ड एज नॉलेज संकल्प शक्ति, सेकंड इज द एनर्जी कॉल्ड एज डायनामिज्म एक्शन, एंड बोथ आर द एक्सप्रेशंस ऑफ द सेम कॉन्शियस रियालिटी. व्हेन टू लाइन्स आर ड्रॉन फ्रॉम द सेम पॉइंट दे कैनॉट बी पैरेलल टू ईच अदर, देयर हैज टू बी एन एंगल. लाइक दिस टू फिंगर्स आर कमिंग आउट ऑफ माई पाम, दे कैनॉट बी पैरेलल, देयर हैज टू बी एंगल. नाउ बी अटेंटिव. एज यू गो अवे फ्रॉम द सोर्स, द डिस्टेंस बिटवीन द टू लाइन्स विल स्टार्ट इंक्रीजिंग. Our sankalpa is one line, our action is another line. When we do not respect our own sankalpa, jnana shakti, in our action, the kriya shakti, the distance between the two starts widening. Net result is, we go away from the source, the pure consciousness that we are. When we honor, respect, demonstrate the knowledge in our every day-to-day activity, then the distance between the knowledge and action starts reducing. And as it reduces, we come to the source, the reality that we are. When knowledge and action merge, there is but one reality. From that point, when anything is thought of, that will happen. But we are far away from the source. Come back to your source. All the great masters, when they casually say something, how it happens? We talk only from the lips. It has no touch of reality. Therefore, our words do not carry the meaning. And when the words do not carry the meaning, it has no impact. See, why the children don't listen to the parents? Because their words don't carry any meaning. See, and the children have known the parents very closely throughout their life. Dad, don't teach me, I know what you are. Therefore, friend, sankalpa is bhavana. So, sankalpa, bhavana, prokta, and these sankalpa or the bhavana, they are of two types. Siddha sankalpa and asiddha sankalpa. Siddha bhavana and asiddha bhavana. See? In Bengali, when the rice is cooked, that cooked rice is called as siddho. Duronto, like Siddho. Siddha means it doesn't have any hardness. You know, when the rice is not properly cooked, if you crush it, it is some kind of hardness in it. So, sankalpo bhavana prokta siddha asiddha iti cha dvidha siddhi sankalpa asambhedha avikalpastu ane katishtate. Now the siddha sankalpa is without any option left behind. Siddha sankalpa is giving oneself zero choice. Whole life will change, friends. This is the meaning of that bhajan we sing without understanding meaning. जेहि विधि राखे राम तेहि विधि रही, एंड देन वी वांट सो मेनी चेंजेस, सो मेनी ऑप्शंस टू हैपन. व्हेन वी लीड अ लाइफ एट जीरो एक्सपेक्टेशन, जीरो डिमांड्स, जीरो डिजायर्स, वी आर प्रोसीडिंग टुवर्ड्स द सोर्स. That is our essential nature. Such a bhavana is called a siddha bhavana. And brahma bhavanaya pashyam jatam jagadidam nano etat sarvaihi satya rupam bhavitam sudrudatvadaha. Now if you look at the world, that is the whole world is nothing but paramatma, brahma bhavanaya. See? Now see how this bhavana is very simple. Not difficult. When we look at the ornaments, we are carried away by the glitter, the name, the form, the desire, the design. But when a jeweler looks at that, he is without any disturbance, only focusing attention whether it is gold or not. Is it not? So his bhavana is siddha. Our bhavana is not siddha. Therefore we get cheated. They cheat us. Think, friends, in the same manner, when we have done this bhavana again and again, that this world is nothing but paramatma. See? This can happen only when we have discovered ourselves to be the same divine reality. On the spiritual path, knowing cannot be without being. If we know the truth without being the truth, we are only imagining. It is not the truth. And imaginations have the knack of changing. See, friends, one day we imagine, oh, it's so very nice, you know. Next day, you know, it's not very good, you know. See, our opinion, everything starts, keep on changing, it is never firm. So when we look at the world by this practice, and this is the practice in devotion that is told. But instead of learning this, seeing one divinity in and through everything and being, what happens is, we are carried away that I am a Krishna devotee, I am a Rama devotee, I am a another devotee. See? When we see, promote, establish and insist on differences, we are lost in the world. When we are able to see the one reality pulsating in and through all the differences, a great saint is born. See, friends, like we see one eye in and through all the sense organs, all the organs of action, all the experiences. Therefore, we have no biasness towards any sense organ, any organ of action, nothing. Exactly the same way, when we look at the world by this Brahma Bhavana, so this world is nothing but Paramatma. Therefore, as I told you, don't have compassion, daya for the world. It is the most insult. See? I'll tell you how this is very bad. There is one lady in somewhere in the USA. Many years before, when she migrated with her husband, she wanted to get her brother there. So she has to first become a citizen of that country. She became. Those days it was very easy. She became citizen. Then she sponsored her brother who came there. He studied she supported his graduation, post graduation, got married. After marriage, that brother stopped coming to the sister, not even talking. So she told me, Swamiji, see, I have done so much for my brother, but he doesn't even care to come and say hello, and he is like that, she is like that. Please do something, tell him. I said, okay. Sometime I happened to meet him. He was such a nice gentleman, full of life and cheer. So again, when I went and saw his sister, I said, Mama, he's such a jolly good fellow, perfectly, a very nice gentleman. Swamiji, with others he is good, but not with me. Why so? I have done so much for him. I said, Mama, I'll tell you, you will not like it. No, please tell. I said, as you have told me 10 times, you have done so much for him, you have done so much for him. To a other person you tell times, you must be telling him every time he is taking the food, I am giving you the food, you know that. Remember one thing, if we look at the world that they are unfortunate and we can help them, we are criminals. Look at the world as God, then you will serve the world. Don't have compassion for anybody. On the contrary, look upon everything and body as God's expression. Will you have compassion for Shivalinga? Are you thanda pani gir raha? No. When we put on the milk on the Shivalinga, that time do you feel that we are wasting the milk? No, because we are suspecting divinity in that. When we can suspect divinity in the idols made by man, can't we suspect the same divinity in his creation? See, friends, so Brahma Bhavanaya Jagat. And we will be able to see this world as God only if we have discovered the divinity that we are. See, I keep on moving so many places, so I can smell the people who is from where. So one day I met one lady in a Marwadi house. They are all Marwadi. So I told her, I said, hey, you may be Marwadi, but you are not a Marwadi. Then you must be a Gujju. She was so shocked. On what ground you said? I said, I have no cause and effect. If you are not, I am happy. If you are, I am happy. But you may be a Marwadi, but according to me, you must be a Gujju. Swamiji, you are 100% right. I was born and brought up in Junagadh. Although we are Marwadis, but I am actually a Gujarati. Her again, but how do you know? I said, again, you are asking questions. No reason. See, friends, in the same manner, when you are abiding in the truth, we will be able to see the divinity and be attentive. Seeing divinity means what? Seeing divinity means looking upon the world with respect and reverence. Nobody deserves anything less than respect and reverence in life. And when we respect or revere somebody, that somebody is never benefited. It is the one who extends the respect, he is benefited. See, friends. One day one person was arguing with me, Swamiji, today I will not leave you. I said, okay, hold on. He said, you call me Mahatmaji, Bhagwan, on what ground? I said, on the same ground where you are standing, I am standing. No, not that way. You know, I am a married person, I am a grihastha, and I got so many problems. And how do you call me God and Bhagwan and Prabhu? I said, I'll tell you the secret. Secret is, when you address anybody respectfully, you are benefited. So I am a selfish person. Just try, you address somebody, Mahatma ji, ek lagaunga kaske. Can you say? See? And you call somebody, you cheat, namaste. You cannot. These are very simple techniques. You don't have to have big, you know, discussions on Brahma Sutra. Koi jarurat nahi hai. Learn from every day-to-day experiences of life. That is all Vedanta teaches us. Vedanta is living with high degree of common sense, which is very uncommon. See? Therefore, Brahma Bhavanaya Pasya Jatam Jagat Idam Nanu. So Idam Jatam Jagat, this whole world is, look upon this world as God or God's creation. See, friends, once I happened to stay in LA with one lady, elderly one, and she was insisting for many years. So one day my people contacted Swamiji, she has been very much after, so we have decided you stay with her. I said, okay, no choice. And first thing I saw in her house, I went inside, opened the fridge. I said, let me have some cold drink. Very elderly lady. On the fridge there was a sticker, big sticker. This house is primarily meant to cater the needs of my dogs and cats. If you find it difficult, you can go out. So I had no choice. There were 7 dogs and 11 cats in that house. So I had to stay with her. I don't like cats and dogs. So when I went and sat, one cat came and sat. Then the dog started sneezing. I thought after sneezing he should not do Purnavada, Purnavidam. They can do anything. See? Even somebody's car is parked, they will go and do that thing and on the car. The tire they do. So that old lady asked, Swamiji, I hope you like these animals. I said, yes, Mama, they are so sweet. When you are staying with somebody, even the useless animals you pretend that you like, then only you will be at peace. I don't like it. But you have to live there. You will be miserable. In the same manner, when you are staying with somebody, you try to appreciate whatever dirty things they have. In one house I went, the house was in a mess. So I said, Mama, I felt so much at home in your house. Why? It is so homely. She was very happy. It was shabby. See? In the same manner, this world created by God, if you are in tune with Him, you will love and like everything in His world. On the path of devotion it is said, look at the world as God looks at the world. How the God looks at the world? Like the mother looks at her useless child. And for the child, that for the mother, whatever useless the child may be, it is a glory. See? The foolishness of the child is wisdom. The dirtiness of the child is bada badmash. When they say badmash, it is a glorification. They are not abusing him. Because it is their child. If it is somebody else's child, they don't treat manners to the children, you know. If we look upon this world, Brahma Bhavanaya Jatam Jagat Pasya, then etas sarvahi satya rupam bhavitam sudrudatvataha. And when you do this practice again and again, then slowly your sankalpa, your bhavana will become strong. Therefore, friends, spiritual practice is not half an hour meditation, rest of the day frustration. No. It is not going 1 minute to the God, Jashu Krishna, have any hurry, ghanti hoja ke chalegi. Nothing will happen. See, friends, it is not a part-time profession. We have to be in this tune 24/7. Then only the truth is revealed. And what is the revelation of the truth? Although we see the differences, but do not get influenced by the differences. Seeing or experiencing the differences is not the problem. The problem is when my daughter-in-law and my daughter are sitting for taking food, so to my daughter I give a little more of Shrikhanda, and to daughter-in-law, she is getting fat, I think. She should not eat, beta, you should not eat. See the difference. Therefore, Brahma Bhavanaya Pashya Jatam Jagadidam Nanu Etat Sarvaihi Satya Rupam Bhavitam Sudrudatvataha. Then you will come to know this world as Paramatma is real, and as the changing panorama of names and form, it is not real. All the ornaments as gold are real, but all the ornaments as name and form are not real. When you call a necklace or a whatever ornaments, I don't know, they are not real. But when you call the ornaments are as gold, they are real. See, the more we become subjective in our experience, then we'll come to know, we will be able to transcend the differences if we go away from the modifications of the body and the mind. So, etas sarvai satya rupam bhavitam sudrudasvataha tatha swasankalpa bhave nasti kasyapi bhavana vikalpa sambhedaha esho asiddha tasmad vibhavana. Therefore, here the teacher says that whatever you think in your sankalpa, others are not taking as real, you only take it as real. Be attentive. When somebody is miserable, see, I don't know, my wife is so terrible, you know, I am so frustrated about it. So our miseries of life, they can never be appreciated by others. But our miseries are solid reality for us. What we think as real, satya, is not accepted by others as satya. On the basis of this, one amma scolded me once. She said, Swamiji, you are always teasing us. So what happened? You always tell, be happy, get married and then show be happy what it is. You will understand. Meaning what? Her world of a married person is full of miseries. Because you are not married, you are happy. So, her world of miseries has no reality for me. Because I am no more involved in that world in the same manner. Observe this. When we go to somebody, something bad has happened, we go there. Do we start participating in that misery with a jugalbandi? No. If he is crying, we also, in Punjab it happens. In Punjab they get paid criers. And there are different rates. If somebody dies, you want to show the shock and miseries, so they get the ladies, they are available there. Everything is, you know, so professional. Ordinary crying, 25 rupees, 15 minutes or 1 hour. And more crying, 50 rupees. And then hitting your chest and rolling on the floor, 100 rupees per hour. So they will know what a great that departed soul was. People are crying after the paisa nikalo. Next place. See? When somebody dies, we go there and we have all the wisdom available to us, is it not? Now we agree this is very bad, should not have happened. Now, but you have to take care of the children. Now you are two in one. You are both mother and father for them. You earn money as a father and you cook food for them as a mother. You make this as your life. And the other person thinks, "Are yaar, you are a great wise person." No, because it happened with you. If it happens with us, all wisdom evaporates. Watch this in life. What is real for me in my sankalpa, in my imaginations, is not real for others. See? Therefore, yatha swa sankalpa bhave nasti kasya bhi bhavana. In our sankalpa, nobody is participating. They don't think it is so misery. Like that, vikalpa sambhedaha eshaha asiddha tasman vibhavanaha. And therefore, our vikalpa is not siddha, it is not firm, because it doesn't include everything. We are living in a kupamanduka vritti, living in a small little world. We are not able to expand. See, friends. When we think all the time only about me, 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 and keep on accumulating so much of money, so much of money, do you think such a person will think about the nation? Those who are all the time thinking about how much more I can take, how much more. We have seen that these days, this is only news. And I do not know how to count beyond 100,000. After that, how many zeros come? And then they say 280 lakh crores of rupees. Arre Ram 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 Ram. Even Bhagwan will not be able to count. Yaar, band karo. And where is that all money? In the beds, in the kitchen, in the toilets. What for? So much small little thinking. Expand. Friends, when we are happy, in the happiness of others, then alone we have really expanded. When we are able to extend a helping hand to the miserable, then alone we are expanding. Expansion is God, contraction is devil. See, friends, nobody has given a degree to Mahatma Gandhi as Mahatma. He was M.K. Gandhi. Mai kyu Gandhi? Then Rabindranath Tagore, he just addressed him as only once, "Hey Mahatma," because he was fakir. See? So what was the greatness in him? Nothing for him, everything for others. See, friends. Therefore, bhavanayaha siddhiratra bahudha samstita bhavet. And therefore, if our bhavana is firm, we can create anything in this world. You will see all the great successful people in life. They were so committed to whatever they did, and they achieved it. So here the teacher says, janmana manina tadvat aushadhena cha yogataha tapasa mantra siddhyacha varena bhavendrupaha. There are different methods of reaffirming or strengthening your bhavana. For example, janmana brahmana savai, somebody has this bhavana by birth like Brahmaji, and manina yaksha rakshasam, the yaksha and the rakshasas. They have the money, they have got different kinds of, you know, stones on their fingers or various kinds of money hanging in their neck, and they have all the bhavana. They can, because of the strength from those money, they have got sankalpa shakti. Further, aushadhena tu devanam, all the various gods, they take different type of vanaspati, and because of that, they get that sankalpa shakti. Therefore, all the gods are offered different type of flowers and leaves. If you put a bilvadala on Lord Narayana, ato, nahi chahiye, mujhe to tulsi chahiye. ऑल दी गॉड्स गेट देयर शक्ति फ्रॉम दिस औषधि. योगी नाम दू योग तो भवे एंड योगीज बिकॉज ऑफ द प्रैक्टिस ऑफ योगा दे अटेन दैट संयम संकल्प सिद्धि. तपसा तापसा नाम सा एंड दोज हु आर तपस्वी बिकॉज ऑफ द तपस्या दे डिस्कवर दिस. वन एग्जाम्पल, तपस्या मीन्स वॉट? When one is obstinate to the core, such people achieve that. But then they become extremely angry. In Puranas, you must have heard the stories. Such and such Rishi went some place and then he asked for something and it was not there, so he cursed. Durvasa went to Draupadi and asked for food. There was one bank manager went to a Udupi hotel. What do you have? That boy gave a list. Idli, dosa, upma, uttamam, dosa, masala dosa, rava dosa, kad. Achha, get me rava dosa, upma and idli. Saab, khatam ho gaya. Why did you tell them? He said, when we go to your ATM, you ask number this, that, and we place it, no money. Maja aya? Kaisa hota hai? Now tell me, in this world, where is the misery? If you are able to look at this world with this light heart, even in the miseries, you can make others also happy. See? But all the time. So, this tapasya, when tapasya is done, in that tapasya what happens? We become very obstinate. And then, that obstinacy is a power of creating or destroying something. So when this Durvasa Rishi went and said, I want food, and there was no money in ATM. So what can you do? Curse. I am coming with my 60,000 disciples. Food should be ready. And Durvasa is known for his anger. See, friends, all these great tapasvi, they are famous only for their anger. You see, the devotees of the Lord. Take for example, Mirabai. Mirabai did not curse anybody. Tukaram Maharaj, he did not curse anybody. Nanak Dev Maharaj, he did not curse anybody. Because it was not done out of tapasya. Don't get lost in this too much torturing the body. See, tapasya is meant only for two things. Number one, discover freedom from things and beings in this world. No more dependent on anybody in this world, no more dependent on anything in this world. When you discover that freedom is called as the result of tapasya. For us, we are so much dependent on so many things. Because the servant is there, doesn't mean we have to get the work done only from the servant. No, but we are paying for that. You are paying for your foolishness. See, friends. And the second thing is discovery of self-confidence. Many of us lack self-confidence and therefore our sankalpa is not siddha. When we say something or when we decide something, we have our own doubts. When we doubt ourselves, our own abilities, how can anybody else be able to accept us? See, friends, therefore, tapasa tapasa namsa mantrikanam tu mantrataha. And those who are the mantrik, they will be doing the various mantra puja, and because of that, whatever they decide, the sankalpa becomes fructifying. Vishwakarma mukhanam cha varapraptya hi sa bhavet. and Vishwakarma, etc. They were blessed by the God because of the blessing. These come sankalpite yatha bhavyam purva visparane sati sthiram tavad bhavetyevam yavat purvam nahi smaret. And our sankalpa also becomes perfect only if during the sankalpa, I am doing the sankalpa, this I principle should not be present and should not bring the past failures in the present moment. See friends, in third chapter, Bhagavad Gita, Bhagavan says, very simple words, mai sarvani karmani sanyasya adhyatma chetasam nirashi nirmamo bhutva yudhyasva vigata jvaraha. This is the technique of sankalpa siddhi. See? When you are committed for something, and what is that something? Mai sarvani karmani sanyasya adhyatma chetasa. Now you have no doubt about it. For whom you are doing and what you are doing, no doubt. And what are the possibilities of doubt? Number one, mamata. Earlier also I tried, but I never succeeded. I hope this time I will succeed. You will guarantee fail. Second thing, and nirashi bhutva. Nirashi bhutva means you do not remain in the present all the time thinking about the future. I am doing this, suppose I get it, and then what will I do? And if I don't get it, then what will I do? Or you remain in the present. So, memories or the failures of the past, worries of the future, and in the present, excitement. Vigata jvaraha. Relax. When these three things are achieved, your sankalpa is bound to be formed. When we doubt ourselves, how can others believe? See friends, therefore, if we really want to achieve success on any field, may it be material or the spiritual, the mind with the firmness alone is the instrument through which we can achieve anything in life. So, sthiram tavat bhaved yetat yavat purvam nahi smaret. So, when our present sankalpa is no more clouded, influenced by the past, good or bad. Meaning, while the sankalpa is done, we must be 100% in the present. See friends, be very attentive. And in that 100% present, if I is not wanting anything, then in that sankalpa rahit manas, that thought free mind is taken possession by the divinity, and from such or through such great masters, what has to be achieved, they never decide. It is the divine will that functions through them. See friends, the sankalpa is nothing but allow His will to express through us, provided we are empty of all desires. And once this happens, our boundaries of life transcend the limited small cul-de-sac where we are bound. Let us get out of it. Therefore, evameva nirvikalpa bhavana yadi susthiraha anichaya vikalpasya yavet sambhedanam nahi. Therefore, till such time, when our bhavana is nirvikalpa, no option. Therefore, in day-to-day life also try this. Do not give yourself too many options. Lesser the choice we give to ourselves, nearer we are to the reality. It's a very simple technique, not very difficult. Give minimum choice. in every field. You see, things will start happening. We have that arrogance. And because of that, our own sankalpa. See, whenever I decide something, it fails. One person came and asked me, he said, Swamiji, whenever I take anything in my hand to do, it goes up to some place, then it fizzles out. I tried many things, but never succeeded. Why? Then I told him, I said, you know, I was also doing the same thing. What? I decided to dig a well. So I dug in 100 places, every place 2 feet. Here 2 feet, no water. Another place 2 feet, no water. On the contrary, dig in one place, all the depth you can go, you will get water. We are not stable. We are in the stable. We have to be stable in whatever we do. For us, sometime we go to Vaishno Devi, Jai Mata Di, Yashin Devi, Shadi Garado, Jai Di Mata, Ye Garado, Jai Mata Di. Few days, the Jai Mata Ji. Then you go from there to Varanasi. Vishwanath Bhole Baba Ki Jai, Vishwanath Baba Ki Jai, Om Namah Shivaya, Om Namah Shivaya, Om Namah Shivaya. Then you go to Srinath Ji. Chappan Bhog. Nowhere we are firmly rooted. And then the question comes, Swamiji, I am confused. Nothing new, tell something different. No, my question is, in the North India, they observe Tuesday for Hanumanji. In our South India, Maharashtra and down below, we observe Saturday for Hanumanji. Which is the real Hanumanji? I said, there are two brands of Hanumanji. One is a North Indian Hanumanji. He is observed on Tuesday. Secondly, the South Indian Hanumanji is observed on Saturday. Who are you? Swamiji, you always cut jokes. I don't have to. You are a joker yourself. Our minds are full of doubts, doubts, doubts. See? Therefore, the more we become extremely subjective, our sankalpa will become firm. Therefore, be attentive. If you are nearer than the nearest to your own being, you will be spontaneous. Spontaneity is an expression of divinity. There is no struggle. Like the mirror is spontaneous. When somebody comes in front of the mirror, mirror doesn't say, "Thodi der ruk ja yaar, main thak gaya. Baad mein aana. Paisa khatam." No. That ease with which a mirror is able to reflect the things, with that ease, the life is lived. Because there are no hang-ups. See, friends. And when we disappear, he takes over. God has not created this world by conducting experiments. Suppose I had to create a happy man, what I had to do? No. It is just like that. So, evameva nirvikalpa bhavana yadi susthira anichaya vikalpasya yavat sambedhanam nahi. And when our bhavana is sthira, no doubts, no confusions, no changes, no options, then tavat sa bhavana siddha, then alone your bhavana will become siddha. Now this we can try in our day-to-day experiences. For example, you are sitting for doing the, let's say, japa. You have to complete one mala. And then doing that one mala, ओम नमः शिवाय, ओम नमः शिवाय, ओम नमः शिवाय, माइंड विल से खत्म करो यार जल्दी, वी हैव टू गो समवेयर फॉर ए मीटिंग, ओम नमः शिवाय, 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 ओम नमः शिवाय. एंड अवर जपा गोज इन सच ए हाई स्पीड, ओम नमः शिवाय, ऑल द गॉड्स गेट कन्फ्यूज, अरे यार किसको बुला रहा है, मेरा तो नाम नहीं है ये. वॉट एवर यू डू, डू इट 100%, मे बी इट इज फॉर 5 seconds, डजंट मैटर, स्टार्ट विद दैट. सी, वी आर नॉट टॉकिंग अबाउट रिलीजियस लाइफ, वी आर नॉट टॉकिंग अबाउट योगा, वी आर नॉट टॉकिंग अबाउट हेल एंड हेवन, वी आर नॉट टॉकिंग अबाउट सक्सेस एंड फेल्यूर, वी आर टॉकिंग टू मर्ज इन द ट्रूथ, दैट इज अध्यात्म. सी फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज द वे टू स्ट्रेंथन वंस ओन भावना, एंड इट इज बिकॉज ऑफ दिस when all the great masters say something casually, it happens. They even do not plan this should happen, but it happens. And they are surprised. Swamiji, you told us it happened. It is none of Swamiji's business. Somebody said it, something happened. And that Babaji is relaxed. Achha beta, theek hai. See. Shirdi Sai Baba never said, I did like this. He is doing. See? The more we are thus in tune with the Divine, when His will, His desire starts expressing through us, then all the sankalpa become siddha. This is how, by a simple word of a great master, an ordinary person became the world-famed person. This happens, it is possible. Therefore, the real spiritual practice is work on the mind and not working by the mind. These two things I told you 100 times, I'll keep on telling shamelessly. This is the only two things, spiritual practice. Work on the mind. Working on the mind is number one. Before we talk to anybody, ask a question, is it necessary to talk? And stop talking to yourself. How much we keep on talking to ourselves? Cock, 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 cock. A poultry farm inside. We are not one, we are a crowd. Wherever there is a crowd, there is no peace. See? If we are all alone and we say, I am getting bored, how can you get bored if you are alone? Because you may think you are alone, but inside there are many people sitting, you know, husband, wife, brother, father, mother, sister, businessman, successful, failure, so many of them. And then one talks, tumko kya hota hai? Husband, shaadi karke tumhe. Lekin yo ladka manta nahi meri baat. Keep on talking to yourself. Try. Take it a firm resolution. Stop talking to yourself. You will naturally withdraw from the world. Om Purnamadaha Purnamidam Purnaat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavashishyate. ओम शांति शांति शांति. हरि ओम. श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः. हरि ओम.